I'm Liz Duplessis, the Instructional Designer in Distance Education at Santa Rosa Junior College. SRJC's Instructional Accessibility Specialist, Corrine Haverinen, demonstrates how to use the WAVE Accessibility Testing Tool for a more in-depth evaluation of individual pages than the Canvas Accessibility Checker provides. First, she shows how to install WAVE as a plugin to Chrome or Firefox browsers by searching for the WAVE Evaluation tool in the Chrome Web Store at this URL. Here's Corrine.
So we're going to just add this to Chrome, and we're going to OK that to add the extension. And you don't have to restart or anything, and it puts it right up here, and it kind of shows you that you have this little icon up here with a W in it, and that's the WAVE tool. So we'll close the Chrome Store, we'll get out of this tab and go back to the page that I want to check. And now I just click on the WAVE tool. And now with this tool I like it because it tells you a lot more about what's going on the page visually. We see my heading structure, the heading one, that's from the title to the page. We can see I get a warning here. Anything yellow is a warning. So I've gone from H1 to H3. And I believe that this tool decided this is a warning because in our standards that we're following, there's three different levels, level A, level AA, and level AAA. And the rule of thumb is you want to do A and AA, and AAA is sort of like the frosting or the gravy. You don't have to, but it's a good idea. And the heading level order is really in AAA, and that's why I think they call it out as a yellow warning. But if I was going in to fix this page, I would go ahead and just take the time to fix this as well. Another thing that can happen really often in Canvas is you'll get an empty heading, and that means you had some type that you typed in as a heading, then you changed your mind or something, or maybe you've copy and pasted something in, and behind the scenes there's a heading tag but there's no text in there anymore, and that is an outright error and we'd like to remove that. So unfortunately, the WAVE tool is just an evaluation tool. It doesn't have an interface for fixing things. So to fix this, you'd go back into editing and you'd see this extra white space and you just hit the delete. So you delete the line, and that's how you would get rid of it. One way. We have another tool to show that show you another way of getting rid of it. This little icon, the squares with the blue in it, is showing that this is a table. And what WAVE does is it can just tell you where there's a table, and it's just letting you know, hey, there's a table there. You need to decide, is this a layout table, such as this one down here, or is it a data table? And if it's a data table, because we don't have any icons in here that would look somewhat like this icon here for the caption, then we know that we need to put header cells in there. And again, we'd have to do that on our own, go into the editing tools to do that. We can't do it from the WAVE interface. It's also going to tell you about alternative text on images. And so we have a little red thing here. If we click on any one of these little icons, it brings up, well, it's gone off the screen a little bit, but it brings up a little tooltip that tells you what's going on, and it says it's missing alternative text. So this one has no alt attribute at all behind the scenes with alternative text put in there. So that's an outright error. We have another out of order heading. We have another table here, and again, it can only tell us about the caption, and then the rest we have to figure out on our own. Another empty heading, and now we go down to another series of images I have in here. So when it's green, it means good. If we click on this, we'll see that it's null or empty alternative text. Now this is really just fine if your image is decorative, like there's no reason to explain what this image is about to the visually disabled person. And I would say that's true in this case. And we have another one here the same way. Here on the left, we have this image of down at Big Sur, I think that's Pfeiffer State Park or whatever. There's a no alternative text there whatsoever, so that's an error. And then this one, it does have alternative text in it, but it's given us a yellow warning because it's warning us, well, we think this is somewhat suspect. And what tipped it off was it said .jpg. So what Canvas does automatically, when you insert an image in a page, it's going to take the name of your file and put it in as alternative text. And 95% of the time, that's just not good enough. I mean, this would be read off as pt-lobos.jpg, which isn't good. So we'd want to fix that again.
Can I ask a quick question?
Yeah.
So the difference between the beach with the dog and Big Sur is that that one has a proper null.
Right.
And this one just doesn't have anything.
This doesn't have anything. Behind the scenes, there's an image tag. And in the image tag, there's alt equals in the code. And if alt equals quote, quote, then that's good code that tells the screen reader software, skip over this image. It's decorative. It's, you know, don't bring it to the attention of the viewer or the user. This one here has no alt attribute whatsoever. So it's just going to be a problem. It's going to call out that there's an image and then give no other information, which would be frustrating to the screen reader
user. So they would click edit, and then in the alt text, little text box, they put two quotes with.
Well, that's a good question. Well, let's go into editing. And if we go into editing, usually it's going to wipe out all this stuff from the Wave tool anyway. But if we went down to an image like...
fix this Big Sur one.
Okay, so the Big Sur one, we'll click on it, and then we click on the embed image icon, and actually decorative image is turned on here. That's really funny, because that's where you usually turn that on. I would just try that again and see if it fixes it. If you want to put alternative text in, that's where you'd put it here, and you'd have to take this decorative image checkbox off. But Canvas added this recently, which is really good, because imagine you have a lot of images in there that are just like decorative borders or something, and they come up like six times on a page. How annoying that would be. So it's really good to have that. Again, I'm not going to apply anything here because I want to keep my errors. So we'll cancel out of that, and we'll just go back to the Wave tool again. I have to say, if you're going to apply this Wave to a page that has a lot of stuff on it, like a discussion page where your students have already responded, it might take a little while for it to do its test. Here we came up pretty quickly. Here in the area on links, I've tried to show various different ways to do links. And what we really want is a descriptive link. And none of these are really the best. You know, this we would say, SCO webinar getting started without the PPTX and without the dashes. We want it to read it off as words, right? PDF is a very small link that might be hard for somebody, especially if they have issues with their hands, to click on. So we'd want to say, what is that PDF? And this is the worst kind, where you just have click
here.
The color I'm going to show you in a minute, it's a different tab in the tool, so I'm going to skip that for now. Down here in lists, this is what I really like. It gives you this little icon when there's a list, and when you hover over it, it shows you the entire list that code is covering behind the scenes. So we have an ordered list here, and there's no little blue icon to show that it's really a list. So this is an error. Unfortunately, it doesn't bring it up as red. I would love to see it do that. But if you see an absence of this little icon, you know, well, okay, so this list needs to be fixed. It's sort of a fake list at this point. This list has a problem because we have two items in this bulleted list, and each one of them is a separate list. So that's going to be confusing to the screen reader user. Down here, this one's done correctly. We have a list, and if we hover over it, we see it goes all the way down through 1, 2, 3. And then we actually have a nested list, and that one's done correctly as well. So let's go back to talk about color. So over here in the left sidebar here, I want to show you a couple things. One thing is, it says there's 11 errors, and if we click on the little flag, it's actually going to show us what those errors are. And then if you click on them, they should take you where in the page that error is. If we click on contrast, that's how it deals with the color. So it says, we don't like these colors here. There's not enough contrast. Now, unfortunately, it's also brought up the blue for the links. Ignore that. That's a Canvas interface thing that's controlled by the Canvas people and not by us. So you're just going to have to ignore that. I don't think it's really way out of whack, but it's just slightly not enough contrast. And of course, we don't have to worry about anything in the interface. So just ignore all the interface stuff and only look at your own content. And so this green comes up, and then these colors for this colored text down comes up. But what's really cool about this, if I click on this red one and it gives me an interface over here, I can actually change the color, and I believe it's going to tell me if it passes. Down here, see how it passes now. And if I click on this green one, see how it says fail. If I just click on the colored box and make a darker color, that wasn't good enough, and then it passes. We're only trying to pass at AA, and this is not large text, so we didn't have to go quite that far. But anyway, this is the one we want it to pass at AA for normal text. So that shows the wave tool.
Thanks, Corrine. Watch more of our videos on YouTube by searching SRJC Distance Education. You can find our playlists, watch videos, like them, share them, subscribe, and add comments. Thanks for watching.